Saidania Vishnu, come over here to your darling. You choose the road, and I make the vow, and I'll be a true love forever. There is the road that in yonder garden grows. There is the lily of the valley. Here is the water that flows from the high. But my down by Killarney, green woods that we stray, the moon and the stars there were shining. The moon shone its rays on her locks of golden hair, and she swore she'd be my love forever. Red is the rose that in yonder garden grows. But my love is fairer than I. It's not for the parting of my sister Jane. It's not for the grief of my mother. He's all for the love of my bunny and his heart. That my heart is breaking forever. Red is the rose that in yonder garden grows. There is the lily of the valley.
Across the foam, although I've often
times a day, in foreign lands to roam. No matter where I wander, true cities near or far, sure my heart is at home in old Ireland, in the county of Armagh. I travel three parts of the county, through new town forced to cross my glen, around by the cap of Mount Norris, and home by black waters again, where the girls are so gay and so hearty, none fairer in Erin. That can court them, let the boys from the county Armagh. It's my own Irish home, far across the foam. Although I walk twice a day in foreign lands to roam, no matter where I wander, and old Ireland, in the county of Armagh. Yes, my heart is at home in old Ireland, in the county of Armagh. Well done, thank you all. Take it.
Thank you. fellas who travel the land in search of the crack with guitars in your hands. You're up down to Liscannor in the county of Clare. You'll find a pub village that's ever so rare. They're up into McHugh's in the centre of town. You'll get a warm welcome from George Yorktown. The one like canary will sing howdy who in the 7 day license of Joseph McHugh. You'll see men from Moher, Lisdone and Rideen, a judge from Lynch and the odd beauty queen. A tinker from Kerry steps in for a glass, for a box of rat poison and oats for his ass. Joe strolls down the bar like a captain on deck. He don't tip his hat and he don't give a rick. If you're Irish or Russian, Spanish or Jew, you'll get a warm welcome from Joseph McHugh. His shop is well stocked for all comers to see, with buckets and brushes, balloons and whiskey. Bullseyes, licorice, all sorts, displayed in glass jars, and an outer space suit just imported from Mars. There's onions right there in a bag with some rope, and a picture of Joe shaking hands with the Pope. The owl parish priest, that's the truth I tell you, he proclaims the old publican Joseph McHugh. He sells streaky bacon, all covered with salt, just to ward off blue bottles from making the halls. He has cups there for coursing, some say that's not fair, but Liscannor is famous for chasing the hare. He's a bachelor game on the market, I hear, and he may make a move by the end of the year. But if his greyhound has pups, he can say to Roo, he'll never get married than Joseph McHugh. Well, there now you have it, the truth I declare, about this small pub in the county of Clare. Where time has stood still, and the old ways remain, and they laugh at computers and smart college brains. So if you're in the fix, find yourself in the jam, want a wife, or a greyhound, or a half pound of ham. You could do a lot worse, it's the truth I tell you, than Cotton the Scanner and Joseph McHugh. Fill them up round the house again, Joseph McHugh.
What for Joe?
Get Jimmy to sing it, Tom.
Jimmy, have you your breath back yet?
Sorry, I'm sorry. The most pleasing thing about it, it's almost a permanent job. When the Afton War is over and the world is sitting free, a consolation I've got, well maybe it's not to be nobody left but me. As I sit at my desk in Washington, in charge of this great machine, more vicious than Adolf Hitler, or deadly to strychnine, and in the evening after a tiring day, just to give myself a laugh, I'll press the button, a playful belt, and I listen for the blast. Well, I am the man, the well-fed man, in charge of the terrible knob. The most pleasing thing about it, it's almost a permanent job. When the Afton War is over, and the world is split in three, a consolation I've got, but maybe it's not to be, nobody left but me. Now if Brezhnev starts his nonsense and makes a nasty smell, with a wink and a nod from Nixon, I'll blast them all to hell. And as for that fella Castro, him with his sugar cane, he needn't hide behind his whiskers, cause I'll get him just the same. Well, I am the man, the well-fed man, in charge of the terrible knob. The most pleasing thing about it, it's almost a permanent job. When the autumn war is over and the world is split in three, a consolation I've got, well maybe it's not to be nobody that with me. If me wife she kicks me out of the bed and me breakfast milk is sour, from 8 until 9 in the morning, you're in for a nervous hour. The button being so terribly close, there's really a dreadful joke about me as a psychopath, that we'll all go up in smoke. Well, I am the man, the well-fed man, in charge of a terrible knob. The most pleasing thing about it, it's almost a permanent job. When the autumn war is over and the world is split in three, a consolation I've got, well maybe it's not, there'll be nobody left but me. Now I'm thinking of joining the army that bans the bomb. They take up a large collection and I'll donate me son. For without it, I am helpless and that's the way it will be. Oh, you don't have to kill the whole ready lot to make the people free. Are calling soft to me. The smell of scented heather brings bitter memories. The wild and lonely eagle up in the summer sky flies high o'er Shannon Golden, where my own Willie lies. I met him in winter time when snow was on the ground. The Irish hills were peaceful and love was all around. Scarcely 21 years old, a young man in his prime. We were married, darling Willie, on the eve of Christmas time. Do you remember, darling, we walked the moonlight road? I held you in my arms, love, I would never let you go. Our arms, they were entwined, my love, all in the pale moonlight. By the fields of Shannon Golden, on a lonely winter night. Then came the call to arms, my love, the hills, they were aflame. Down from the silent mountains, the Saxon strangers came. I held you in my arms, love, my young heart wild with fear. By the fields of Shannon Golden, in the springtime of the year. You fought them, darling Willie, all through the summer days. I heard the rifles firing in the mountains far away. I held you in my arms, love, and your blood ran free and bright. And you died in Shannon Golden on a lonely summer's night. Now that was long ago, my love, your son grows fine and tall. The hills, they are at peace again, the Saxon stranger's gone. We'll place a red rose on your grave beneath the pale moonlight, and we'll think of Shannon Golden on a lonely winter's night.
Thank you. It's just a year ago today I left old Erin's Isle. My heart was throbbing in the soft light of my colleague's smile. In all my dreams I seem to hear her sweet voice soft and low. I know she's waiting where we said goodbye in Oslo. Now two Irish eyes are smiling, and an Irish heart is pining. Well, I kissed her and you caressed her in the glowing light of the rose. Loving Irish arms were pressing, as your Irish love caressing, as the Irish lips were pressing. When it's been lighting late on, to our Irish eyes are smiling, and an Irish heart is pining. Where I kissed her and the rest of her in the glowing light of the moon. Loving Irish arms are pressing, and hear the dove coo 'neath the morning sunbeam, where the thrush and the robin their sweet notes entwine. Hide the banks of the shore that flows down by Moonkine. Flow on, lovely river, flow gently by the water so pure, sounds the lark's merry song. On your green banks I wander, where first I did join with you, lovely Molly, the rose of Moonkine. Oh, Molly, dear Molly, it breaks my fond heart to know that we two forever must part. But I'll think of you, Molly, while the sun and moon shine by the banks of the shore that flows down by Moonkine. She sailed far the deep rolling foam, far away from her friends and her dear Irish home. where the roses still blossom and the trees still outline by the banks of the shore that flows down by Mooncoin. Flow on, lovely river, flow gently along by the water so pure. Sounds the lark's merry song. On your green banks I wonder where first I did join with you, lovely Molly, the rose of Mooncoin.
Your dear old parents you must leave behind. Go seek your fortune, darling dear, in a land beyond the seas. Far in Paddy land, but poverty you'll find. These were the words my father spoke when I left Owl Ireland. His sad farewell keeps in my memory still. So I packed my bundle on my back and I left forevermore. From that little town, my cabin on the hill, for the roof is thatched with straw and the walls as white as snow. On the turf where boil the pots I see it still. Owl Ireland's craving in my heart, the place where I was born, in that little owl cabin on the hill. I dreamt I saw the turf fire, it attracts my father's gaze. My dear old mother sitting by his side, his pipe is lit and the smoke is sent. He is thinking on the time when he sent his darling boy beyond the tide. No more I'll join in the merry dance upon the cabin floor. So the music of the bagpipes loud and shrill, no more I'll join in those happy scenes as I did in days of yore, in that little owl cabin on the hill. For the roof is thatched with straw and the walls as white as snow, on the turf fire boils the pots I see it still. Owl Ireland's craving in my heart, the place where I was born, in that little owl cabin on the hill.
And of all the fine places that I've ever been, there is none to compare with the cliffs of Dunleen. Take a view o'er the mountains, fine sights you'll see there. You'll see the high rocky mountains on the west coast of Clare, the towns of Kilkeith and Kilrush can be seen. From the high rocky slopes, from the cliffs of Dunleen, it's a nice place to be,
on a fine summer's day, watching all the wildflowers that ne'er do decay. The hares and lofty pheasants are all plain to be seen, building homes for their young round the cliffs of Dunedin. Fare thee well to Dunedin, fare thee well for a while, and to all the fine people I'm leaving behind, to the streams and the meadows where late I have been, and the high rocky slopes round the cliffs of Dunedin.
Thank you. Thank you.